Now for Hudson. Shannon on the far side saying he wants it in the air. Nice little one-two there with ball. Hudson turning it in. Oh, and that went right across the face of the goal. If anything, Shannon dummied McDonald as well. Gillard turning it back again. And the Germans under a lot of pressure there. But they got out of the hole. And here's Holzenbein. Holzenbein again. Bell. Hudson. Lovely little 1-2 Hudson and Ball played there that opened the way for England a moment ago. Gillard's gone down the left to make himself available for Hudson. Here he is. But Bertie Vogts will get there before Keegan. Sir Alf, you wanted to say something?
The England team are playing, settling down very well and very quickly, and I thought this last movement, the 1-2 between Alan Ball and Hudson, was an extremely good movement, and it was a bit unfortunate that we didn't get a touch inside the 18-yard box.
Well, it's another England throw. And Hudson is leaving it for McDonald. Giving the ball a wipe. Looks as though he might try a nice long one now. Shannon is waiting in the middle there, so too is Keegan. And Beckenbauer got it away as far as Costetta. Bell with a long shot, a ricochet just over that German crossbar. Corner to England. The Germans don't agree, but that was a long shot by Bell. And that could have been a very nasty ricochet indeed. So a corner which Keegan's going to take. Here was the deflection. Todd getting in. Whitworth with time to consider what's open to him. Keegan playing the 1-2 back to Whitworth again. Ball, I would imagine, screaming for it there and getting it. Through to Hudson again for England. There seemed no way through there, and McDonald couldn't get it onto his famous left foot. Bell with the shot and is blocked by the Germans. Watson saying, let me have a go. Whitworth playing it first time, trying to get through for the 1-2 off McDonald. Out. And a good deal of accurate first-time passing on a rather difficult surface. Hudson now with a chance to float a free kick in. Watson already up on the far side. And Bell, yes! 1-0 to England. And Colin Bell is the scorer. There was a deflection there for the credit to Bell.
The free kick was taken by Alan Hudson. Coleman threw himself at the ball, didn't get it. Colin Todd struck a goal, a good effort. It came off a defender and the goalkeeper, Meyer, was unsighted.
And England in the mood to accept anything. Here's Holzenbein for West Germany. Coleman. Well, that's the sort of spirit that England need tonight, and it's Kevin Keegan leading the way. Through to McDonald on that left foot. Oh, and wonderful save by Meyer. That's the first time we've had a chance of seeing that thunderous left foot of McDonald's. Stopped by Hudson. Good quick challenge there by Hudson, and a good quick recovery as well as he finds Colin Bell. Shannon up hard, really aggressively going at this West German defence. Here's Hudson. Played into McDonald's area there. Wasn't too far from that. You expect those tremendous drives, and here's a bit of delicate skill.
Malcolm McDonald coming in on his left foot. He makes space to get his shot in, and just unfortunately, just a little too high. A great shot.
Now it's with Holzenbein. Flurry to Bonhoff. Oh, straight between Whitworth's legs, and here's Bonhoff now. For West Germany, hit hard and low. Oh, what a deflection there! And Gillard, no! There's the shot again, blocked once more by Ritzel. And England really were in trouble there from the moment Bonhoff managed to trick Whitworth. But it's still not away, as Bertie Vogts now has a chance to turn it in again. Costetta right up there, and Whitworth Chapman, follow this one out for him. Now Kevin Keegan. Busy little stride, but will he get past Kerbel? Yes, he will. And he's found Whitworth. Hudson away on the right. Here's Hudson. Time to measure his cross, and it'll come for Keegan again. Now Ball, can he get a shot in? No, he flicks it instead for Gillard. Across the face of the goal again, and Gillard was no more than a yard wide. Good build-up by England, thoughtful all along the way.
This was a very good attack by the England team. It was quick, it was decisive, and Gillard was a little unfortunate when he hit the shot and pulled it just a little too wide of the post.
That time the pass fell to Whitworth, and here's Ball to Bell. Coleman. I think Bonoff will get to that one. And Bell was in there to McDonald. Hit well! And Bell, is this number two? Oh my goodness, no! Well, Sir Alf, they couldn't have got closer than that.
No, it was very, very good. Malcolm McDonald, a tremendous shot, followed in by Colin Bell. Colin Bell and Mike Shannon, I feel, thought it was going in. Mike Shannon followed it past the post. Very, very unfortunate.
Hudson, back for Ball. Played down for Shannon. Challenge from behind, which is unfair. And the free kick already taken, and here's Ball now. With the cross as McDonald comes in, yes! McDonald number two. Well, all that stemming from a quickly taken free kick. The first goal he scored for England from Malcolm McDonald, putting England 2-0 into the lead.
A foul on Mike Shannon, a quick free kick by him to Alan Ball, and a great cross to the far post. And Malcolm McDonald, Meyer had no chance. McDonald had it all the way, and it finished up in the back of the net. It was a great movement, great. And great thinking, accuracy in passing and also in finishing. Well, you know, it's often said that all left-footed players, that is, predominantly left-footed players, appear to be awkward, and that would apply to Ian Gillard, I think.
Well, he's had a good first international so far.
He certainly has.
But now look at Keegan. As the West Germans come back quickly in defence, but there's Colin Bell on the far side. Oh, bad luck for him. Tremendous break by England, Keegan leading the way, and both Bell and McDonald were unmarked on that far side of the German penalty area.
It was a great movement forward. The ball was played across the face of the goal. Colin Bell never quite got hold of it or controlled it, but his final effort just went over the bar. It was a very good movement.
And McDonald versus Beckenbauer, and McDonald might come off best. Oh, Beckenbauer! Well, that's an extraordinary situation. Well, we've seen before how players have been hauled back by defenders in a desperate situation. It's the first time I've seen them grab a ball as Beckenbauer did there. And the crowd not at all happy with that bit of gamesmanship. And England get no more than a free kick when it looked as though McDonald must be through. Well, it's on to McDonald's left foot again now. Trying to get a 1-2 going. And the ball played forward now. And Todd belting after it. And I think he'll get there before Holzenbein. Now it's with Bell. For Hudson. Shannon. Break for the West Germans in spite of Hudson's attentions. Heinke is trying to go in. Heinke is who's on for Costella. Costella, the number nine, has been taken off. Bell making a great run down the left, and Keegan couldn't quite pick him up. Now Hudson. Play for Keegan. Willing those legs to get there before the ball goes out of play. Very, very damp in that corner in particular. But here's Keegan again, played now for Hudson. He's got time to let one go, and he has, and it's wide. with Gillard. Now with Ball. Bell found some space for himself down there. And what a lovely ball now for Mike Shannon. There's the cross. Oh, and Whitworth came roaring in there. Keegan might get his shot in. Tries a little floater. He's hit the crossbar. Bell couldn't get it back in. Oh, what a marvellous piece of thinking, though, by Keegan.
Again, this was a great effort by Kevin Keegan. The ball came out to him, he carried it. One thought he'd lost his opportunity of shooting. He clipped the ball, he picked his spot, and it hit the crossbar and came out. Colin Bell followed in.
Well, that was the final full point on the end of the evening, Sir Alf, and a victory for England by 2-0. Your overall impressions?
A very good match, a very good match for the England players. They thoroughly enjoyed it. And a great result. The Germans came here to win. They didn't win due to the fact that they were playing against or met a better team on the day.